Hello everybody and welcome back to this tutorial. Now this thing has finished. As you can see, it says no columns found. This can happen, perfectly legit thing to happen. Let's try something else. You see there is a table user, but there are no columns in it, so nothing has been placed within it, and that can be a pain, but oh well. It does happen from time to time. I deliberately left it here just so I can show it to you. Let's try a different one. Let's try the one that I know that there's useful stuff in. So dvwa dash dash tables. Excellent. There we go. It immediately fetches it. Now keep in mind that I am doing this locally. So the web server is on the same machine from which the attack is being generated, and that gives me a speed advantage. That gives me a tremendous speed advantage. That enables me to do stuff really fast. However, if you are out there on the net and if you have a slow connection, if the database is far away, and even worse, if the connection is bad on the other end, this can take a while. So these things tend to take a good amount of time, and don't be surprised if it runs for a while, because that's just the reality that we have to accept and live with. Anyway, we got users, we got guest book, so let's have a look at users, because I know that there was something useful there, but you won't know. So go through all of them. If you're doing a genuine pen test, go through everything that you can get. Go through every single table, go through every single column, go through every single database, see what is in there. I cannot emphasize this enough. How many times did people suffer needlessly, primarily because they were just too lazy to go through the stuff that they already had. So let's just go ahead and type in dash t users. And you cannot tabify anything here. You gotta type in everything pretty much manually, which is a drag, but that's the way it is. Press enter. Excellent, so there we go. This finished really fast. As I said, this is not gonna be the case in the real world, or maybe it will, but it is very unlikely, primarily because of the speed limitations. Anyway, we got a column here. We have a type. Type tells us what sort of information is stored within this column. For example, int is a number, so an integer. That's the English word for it, integer, a whole number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 0, I'm pretty sure that even, yes, if you say unsigned, if it's by any chance it says unsigned int, then it doesn't have any negative numbers, but if it's just int, then it can be, I don't know, minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. Now, 1.26 is not an integer, it is a floating point number. So if you have ints, basically it just means numbers, that's it. Varchar, I'm pretty sure that's just characters, strings, or some sort of strings are placed in there. I don't think it's any, it could be like complex strings, where you, sorry, not complex strings, just regular strings where you can have spaces. It could be C strings where you cannot have, where you have like every individual character or something like that, no spaces, whatever. I'm not exactly sure how that works. I would have to revise some of my programs because I'm not really good with theory, but I can make it work in practice. Anyway, soon enough you will see what is contained within those columns, and then you will be able to judge for yourselves. If I've made some mistakes here, please forgive me. So let's just go ahead and delete this and type in C user, and this is basically column, for so C for column, T for table, D for database. Really simple, plain English language. There isn't, I don't know, there aren't any complicated sets of commands that you need to type in here. For example, here the only thing that you need to pay attention at is the delimiter for cookies. So semicolon basically takes apart two types of cookies, and you specify it here, the cookie, and you specify it here, and just say equals and this. So no big deal there. Mainly just equal signs, slashes, colons, semicolons, etc., dashes, but for arguments, when you're passing them arguments to a program such as Sqlmap, usually those arguments will reflect what will reflect their purpose. So for example, you want to list columns. What are you going to do? Type in dash C for columns. You want tables, dash T for tables. Databases, dash D for databases. Very simple. You don't need to invest much thought into it. It's plain simple English language there. And if I want more than one column, I can just type in comma and specify another one. It's pretty easy, so no big deal there. I can say password. And I'm going to go ahead. Sure. Let's take the first name and last name as well. First name. And last name. Excellent. So these things can be pretty long, and you don't want to type all of them. So why not? Well, you don't have the screen for it, basically. If you have too many of these things, they will crowd your screen and you won't be able to see anything. You won't be able to make heads or tails out of it. So just take a smaller amount of them at a time, a smaller amount of columns at a time, like take 2, 3, maybe 4. Have a pretty big screen here and let's see if it's gonna fit or not, maybe. Okay, so shutting down, what happened here? Rejection, total HTTP request, resuming. Something prior to. Okay, I probably misspelled something. First name, last name. Okay, let's just take in user and password and then take first name and last name separately. Come on, what are you doing to me? Let's check the command out once more. Ah, of course. I've been taking it all, but I didn't dump it anywhere. I'm a brilliant person, I gotta tell you that. Do you want to store hashes to a temporary file for eventual further processing with other tools? Now, what just happened to me, these things tend to happen to anyone, no matter at what level. So don't worry about it, just don't lose your nerves over it. I cannot emphasize enough how important it is to stay calm. If you can't stay calm, leave the machine as it is, lock it, go have a walk or something, or take a glass of water, a tea, whatever. Come back after 15 minutes, continue working. Believe me, you will figure out a solution far faster than just smashing against your keyboard or something of a kind. Anyway, it says 1337, hack me, and then we have some sort of a hash here. That's probably a password, depending on how we actually use this. So it says fetching columns user, first name, last name, password. What do we got here? Retrieve. I don't see first. Ah, there we go. So apparently these are admin, Gordon. So this is the first name, this is the last name, and what on earth have I requested here? Let's just have a look. Ah, I'm skipping it again. Apparently this is the user. So that would be the user name, I'm guessing, but we will see this very shortly. But just by looking at this, you can conclude a lot. So I'm guessing this is the first name, this is the last name, this is the password, and this is the user name. This is what you type in as a user. Yep, Gordon B, and this is Gordon, and then Brown, and then a hash. Yep, I do believe that I am correct. Next up, as I said, there is this question it's asking you, so you can store these hashes and then individually crack them, because you cannot use them as they are. You need to actually figure out a password from this, which is, if the password is shorter, if it's some sort of a word from an English dictionary or something like that, combined with some numbers or something of a kind, yes, sure, it can be cracked within a reasonable amount of time. If you have some sort of a password like me on my main machine, no, you're just not going to be able to crack it. It's going to be, even if you were able to crack 8 million attempts per second, attempt to crack it 8 million times per second, it would take you more than a decade. far more than a decade, I can't calculate that. But usually that means that the password is longer than, I don't know, 8 characters, and that it has all sorts of things in it. I don't know, like numbers, signs, capital letters, lowercase letters, etc. And that can be problematic, especially if it's in the realm of 12 or 13, then yeah, goodbye. you're not gonna be able to crack this hash. You're better off at attempting to do something else. But anyway, for this tutorial, we're gonna try to crack it with a default dictionary that is here, but you can also implement other dictionaries, and you can use other tools as well to crack these hashes. You can implement customized dictionaries, you can implement custom ranges, and then generate passwords from those ranges to attempt to crack this, and stuff of a kind. So there are a good amount of options out there for you, but just a keynote, a reminder, you wouldn't believe, I mean, you literally would not believe the sort of passwords people use on their main servers, on their gateway routers, which are the entry points to their networks and the building or something like that. I don't know, I have seen passwords literally on a router which is used to exit onto the internet for a company. Username admin, password admin. How fascinating can that be? I don't know, people actually sometimes don't pay attention to these things, but there are a large amount of passwords out there which simply are not of any use. If you can get the hash, you will crack it for sure. So be positive, be optimistic as far as that part is concerned. But from time to time, you will encounter somebody that actually uses proper passwords, and you simply won't be able to do anything with a hash there, but there are always other methods, as I've said. Anyway, you can store them, but I don't want to store them. Let's give Sqlmap a chance to actually crack them with a default dictionary. Yep, there is a dictionary-based attack, so you can type in yes. Default dictionary file. Okay, so it can use a default. You can specify a custom file. A custom dictionary file you can download from the net. Just type in dictionary files for password brute force or something like that. You can get them pretty much on a lot of places on the net. Try to find the ones that is most suited to your purpose. Generally type in your search queries on the net, type in what sort of a password are you trying to crack. Perhaps what type of a site is it, or something of a kind. You can also have file with a list of directory files, which is very interesting as well. So you can have a list of directory files within a file, and you can try multiple dictionaries from websites. The good thing with this is that you don't need necessarily store all the dictionaries on your computer, because they can be pretty large. You can store a couple, try them out, store a couple of, delete them, download a couple of others, try them out, and so on and so forth. Anyway, I'm just going to use the default one, which is press enter. Do you want common password suffixes? Slow? No, I don't want them. Let's see what you're going to do, how you're going to crack it. It says multi-processing hash cracking is currently not supported on this platform. I am on a virtual machine, so give me a break here. This is working as fast as it possibly can. It only has one processor core assigned to it if I didn't actually do anything. So you see there is stuff happening here. It's doing some of the things. Do you want to crack them via dictionary-based attack? Okay, so this is asking me for my current username and password that I'm using. Sure, why not? You see it says admin, admin, admin. That's what I've been using. It says password. And it says that there is the hash for a password, and then there is the actual password. Last name, first name, user, that's it. If we go back up, you can see that we have actually retrieved pretty much everything for other users on the site. So we have cracked this one, we cracked this one, this one as well, And okay, I do admit this is generally not the type of passwords that people will use, but they will probably use something relatively similar. Maybe there will be a couple of numbers or something like that, which is nothing too difficult to crack, especially if it's a dictionary word or English name. That's gonna fly for sure. Anyway, now you can use these credentials to log into a website and basically obtain access. Especially if you can log in as admin, that's kind of ridiculous, but yeah. Anyway, what I want to say here is, I don't know, sometimes people have asked me, well, you have the hash, like, why can't you do that? Why can't you just pass it as a password? Isn't it the same thing? No, not really, because the website on the other end, it takes this word as a password, it runs it through some sort of mathematical algorithm, which converts it into this. It encrypts it, in essence. And then it compares what it has encrypted here and compares the encrypted form of this. So it compares the encrypted form of Charlie, to the encryption which it stored on its own, within its own table somewhere with the on the disks, on the server disks somewhere. If you were to pass this in, this would get encrypted and it wouldn't be the same as the encrypted version of Charlie, definitely. So you can't actually pass this. There is a method called pass the hash for Windows password cracking, but that is a subject for another time. If you wish, feel free to take a look at it on the net. Anyway, I bid you farewell, and I hope to continue this in the follow-up tutorial. We'll see what we will do there. Until then, I bid you all farewell.